Hello guys. Today I'm going to react to automotive stuff, aka Carmighty. So as you can see, he basically moved automotive stuff into his new channel called Automotive Stuff. So basically, automotive stuff got a new home. And I mean, I remember when he used to do automotive stuff on his channel, on his main channel, Carmighty. So yeah, that looks interesting. This was made 3 weeks ago. This video introducing the Mercedes G sedan. I mean, I haven't done any reaction video to automotive stuff, so I mean, I have watched his I mean, I remember when I watched his older automotive stuff on his main channel. So anyway, so let's see what this is about and let's begin.
In today's episode, a Mustang will try to kill. A Porsche will
Jeez.
Do the same. And a truck will severely fart. Since the war in Ukraine started, sanctions prevented German luxurious vehicles from being exported to their most profitable customer, the Russian oligarch's son. However, this guy found a solution on how to reuse what is already there. He combined the Mercedes 200. Curva. He combined the Mercedes W210 with a G-Class Mercedes.
That's cool, actually. I mean,
is it weird that I actually like it? By the way, the leftover parts
like
didn't go to waste. He did the same to the G-Class.
Oh, wait.
Is it weird that I actually like it? By the way, the leftover parts didn't go to waste. He did the same to his G-Class.
I mean, oh, okay, it didn't get wasted.
Actually like it? By the way,
no,
the leftover parts didn't go to waste. He did the same to his G-Class.
That's cool, actually.
Russians are crazy. If you're ever on a road trip with friends and your car breaks down,
true.
Just remember that you can start your car again with the power of friendship. Don't believe me? These guys show you how to do it.
I mean, true. The power of friendship.
Because the internet is so full of spectacular WRC rally crashes, here is how it looks like when rally cars go all out with success.
Wait, sorry, I don't want to waste your time, I'm just going to replay this once again what he said.
Here is how it looks like when rally cars go all out with success. That's what makes this motorsport category the one that requires probably the biggest balls out there. Speaking of huge balls, did you know that motorcycle riders are 28 times more likely to die in an accident? Anyways, here is a clip of the Amoy Road Race, a motorcycle race so extreme that they are actually flying over the asphalt.
I mean, it's actually dangerous if you think about it.
Who said that Mustangs can only drive in straight lines and not on real racetracks?
Just replay and listen to it.
And not on real racetracks.
Sorry, I just.
Who said that Mustangs can only drive in straight lines and not on real racetracks? Who said that Mustangs can only drive in straight lines and not on real racetracks?
Thank you.
Me. I said it. Me. I said it. This is a special driving technique straight from Japan, where everything is better. This one is called edging the spin.
Wait.
This one is called edging the spin.
I just keep the captions. The subline, the subline. You also call them captions, I guess you can.
There's a secret conglomerate on Instagram that is fixated on distributing crane propaganda, and what you're about to see is what secret conglomerate on Instagram that is fixated on distributing crane propaganda, and what you're about to see is one of the latest releases. Also, today I learned that hashtag crane porn is a thing on Instagram. Don't call yourself a true car enthusiast if you don't drive a manual. Don't call yourself a true car enthusiast if you don't drive a manual. I mean a real manual. Thank you.
Bro clicked run as administrator.
They managed to fit 3.8 liters of pure muscle and calcium into this small Volkswagen Beetle. The sound is like no other.
Hey, no rabbit.
Story time. While I was pumping gas, some hobo told me that he once saw a racing boat do a full backwards flip, landed safely and continued the race like nothing happened. Straight like that. I didn't believe him until I saw this video. This happened during the U40 bucket list racing event, and while the driver, Dustin Eccles, was fine, the boat may have suffered some serious damage. Impressive nonetheless.
That's dangerous, but damn.
Yo, hold up, is that the sound of ice caps melting?
Or can you say props? I don't know. Actually, I don't know what... I mean, I have heard that word props before, but I don't know if I know the meaning. Or the slang of what slang word means.
Yo, hold up. Is that the sound of ice caps?
I mean, that was impressive.
Yo, hold up. Is that the sound of ice caps melting? Wait, what is this? Oh, yeah, this is the replica of the Panzerkampfwagen 5 Panther Sonderkraftfahrzeug 171 on a Soviet tank chassis at the Gryf Museum in Poland. It requires some Slavic genetics to pull off a move like that. Jake brakes are usually built into only big semi-trucks.
I've listened to that song.
Jake brakes are usually built into only big semi-trucks, but someone did this to his regular work truck. That's pretty cool.
I know it's annoying to you guys, but I still wanna listen once again. Lava.
Jake brakes are usually built into only big semi-trucks, but someone did this to his regular work truck. That's pretty cool.
Jake brakes, okay, I don't know. I mean, I love cars, but... In simpler words, Jake brake is a form of engine braking. Cool, I guess.
The fact that rally drivers can be turned into washing machines and still walk away from... The fact that rally drivers can be turned into washing machines and still walk away from it completely fine is baffling.
Oh, jeez.
What's even more impressive is that the co-driver was still holding the pace notes. Did you notice that?
Yeah.
This guy was driving his car down the German Autobahn. When he felt his car vibrating and while checking the tire pressure to see if anything was wrong, he saw this.
I don't care if it's an auto. I don't care if the subtitles are automatic.
He saw this. To see if anything was wrong. Autobahn. When he felt his car vibrating and while this guy was driving his car down the German Autobahn. When he felt his car vibrating and while checking the tire pressure to see if anything was wrong, he saw this. A couple of wild Leopard 2s going full speed on the German Autobahn, yeah? This is good. Also for good measure, here are a couple of them in Switzerland. I wonder how cool the tank drivers feel during public driving. A couple of wild Leopard 2s going full speed on the German Autobahn, yeah? This is good. Also for good measure, here are a couple of them in Switzerland. I wonder how cool the tank drivers feel during public driving. Here is proof that if men see fast car, man is happy.
Happy face.
This guy gives a new meaning to the definition of muscle car. Question is, how many reps can it do until failure?
Okay.
This car is so loud it got the spirit realm throwing shit at it just to make it stop. This car is so loud it got the spirit realm throwing shit at it just to make it stop. Here you can see the infamous Audi R10 TDI race car driving around track.
Okay.
The Audi R10 TDI is a race car which was developed as a Le Mans prototype 1 for endurance racing. It hosts a 5.5-liter twin-turbo V12 diesel engine producing well over 600 horsepower.
Damn.
Precisely 640, and is the first diesel-powered car to win the 24 Hours of Le Mans in 2006, totaling 3 wins in its entire career. The previous few sentences were generated by AI because I was too lazy to write a script. The previous few sentences were generated by AI because I was too lazy to write a script.
It's not true. I am a very proficient writer and I would only use AI for inspirational uses or to slightly expand on existing knowledge. I do not copy entire texts of AI into scripts because I do not want to do that work myself. Love, Postbode 007.
The cameraman in the next clip is a good example of someone who knows what he's doing. During a race, he anticipated the incoming spin out of the car in front of him and managed to get out of the way well in time.
Okay, it's actually annoying if I replay the video, so no problem. Okay.
Some racists really need to learn from this guy. That's everything for today.
Okay, actually I want to replay. I just like to
in front of him
and listen once again if I didn't.
Someone who knows what he's doing. During a race he entered. The cameraman in the next clip is a good example of someone who knows what he's doing. During a race, he anticipated the incoming spin out of the car in front of him and managed to get out of the way well in time.
Okay, I don't understand every clip of this, but
some racists really need to learn from this guy. That's everything for today. Thank you so much for watching. And have a nice day. That doesn't
make sense. Yeah, you have a nice day as well. Though it was automotive stuff. Though it was 3 weeks ago. Yeah, actually, yeah, that was a good one. So, yeah, actually, it's good that YouTubers, when they have do some... when they do some kind of a content or whatever, when they do, okay, let's put for example automotive stuff. He used to do it on his main channel CarMighty. So it's actually good that he separated it, or can you say separated it, and he made a certain channel for these type of videos. So that's actually, I like it. And yeah, okay. Yeah, it was good. So if you enjoyed this video, then you can like and subscribe to automotive stuff. And you can also like and subscribe to me if you want to. So, okay. Yeah, so have a nice day and bye. Mercedes 200 kurwa. Any more Polish bad words, please?